Christmas morning and celebrate that Jesus was born over 2,000 years ago and can be born in all of our hearts as we look to him this day. I'm going to start off by lighting our open candles and a really warm welcome, especially to those that are joining us who haven't been before. It's really great to see you with us today and hope that you really enjoy this time. Tim's going to come and help us with the lighting of the open candle, so I'd like to invite you to come up to do that for us now, Jo. So the first candle, it reminds us of the patriarchs and the leaders of Israel. The second candle reminds us of the prophets of Israel. They looked forward to the coming of a king who would bring about justice and peace. The third candle reminds us of John the Baptist, sent to prepare the way for Jesus. The fourth candle reminds us of Mary, the mother of Jesus. Bless the Lord, ye servants of the Lord. And the central candle, that white one, reminds us of Jesus, our Saviour, the one whom we eagerly await and rejoice for his presence amongst us. Let's pray together. Lord Jesus Christ, whose advent all shall see, let your coming be the triumph, not to our shame. Let your coming be with glory, but not to our surprise. Let your coming be with justice, but not to our judgments. Make our love burn bright for you, our loyalty endure, and our faith increase. That with you we may rejoice on that day, and so enter into your eternal kingdom. Amen. We've got a clip now, Christmas according to kids.
The angel said, a new baby is given to the king of the Jews. The angel received. He's adorable.
He's gonna be our best friend.
I love you, and you're the best baby I've seen. There, I said
it. Your baby's gonna change the world.
Baby is going to change the world, and we're here today because we want to recognise us at the very start of this Christmas day. So let's respond with the words in Volto. Do I not fill heaven and earth, says the Lord?
Now the word is made flesh and made in a narrow manger.
From eternity to eternity, you are God.
And now we see you as a newborn child.
It's like Carol's going to bring us a drum. So I looked, and I could start to see the shape of a figure. It's surrounded by light. It was an angel. Well, I got up to my feet as fast as I could, and I gave Nathaniel a kick, and Joel, and he got up, and in the moment we were hugging one another in sheer terror, because, just don't know, I don't know what it was this strange light, brighter than it seemed to be around us, and then this angel, he started speaking, I'm not kidding, he said, as clear as day, we sort of heard him, the three of us, with our hearts and with our ears all in one go. And he said, and I'm not kidding with you, he said, and I'll not forget this to my dying day, he said, these were his words, "Fear not, for this day in the town, in the city of David, will be born a Messiah, the Lord, and this is the sign. You will see a child, a baby, lying wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And then there were hundreds of them, hundreds of angels. They filled the sky, and with the light and the music, and they were laughing and singing and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and peace on earth
to all those in God's favour. And they're never gone. Just gone. But we looked at one another, just to make sure we'd all heard the same thing. And the sheep, all that time, had been really quiet, but now they started to bleat, make a commotion, right? Commotion. But we, you know, a shepherd would never leave his sheep for anything. But we had a chat and we just knew what we had to do. So we legged it down the mountainside all the way into Bethlehem. And our feet seemed to know where to take us. Seemed to know where to go. And we got there, and you know, it was just as the angel had said. There in this, we found them in this stable with this baby in a box of hay. Looking for all the world, just like any baby. And for all that light and that heavenly host that we saw, he did look rather ordinary. And I was just telling his mum about all the angels and the heavenly host. And she didn't seem a bit surprised. She just smiled.
Let's just be aware of our need for the Lord to intervene in our lives and bring us that forgiveness. Lord God, our Father, you sent your Son full of grace and truth. Forgive our failure to receive him. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Jesus, our Saviour, you were born in poverty and laid in a manger. Forgive our greed and rejection of your ways. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Spirit of love, your servant Mary responded joyfully to your call. Forgive the hardness of our hearts. Lord, have mercy.
Lord,
have mercy. May the God of all healing and forgiveness draw you to himself, that you may behold the glory of his Son, the Word made flesh, and be cleansed from all of your sins through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Going into a time of sun worship, if you're comfortably able, please stand.
Yeah.
as I come up again to bring us us. Reading is taken from Titus chapter 2, verses 11 to 14.
For the grace of God has appeared that offers salvation to all people. It teaches us to say no to ungodliness and worldly passions and to live self-controlled, upright and godly lives in this present age.
While we wait for the blessed hope, the appearing of the glory of our great God and Saviour, Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us to redeem us from all wickedness and to purify for himself a people that are his very own, eager to do what is good. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We have our gospel reading now.
Let's stand to the reading of the Gospel. Hear the Gospel of our Lord
Jesus Christ, according to Luke 1:2-14. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Saviour has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly hosts appeared to the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and peace on earth to those on whom his favour rests." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, my God.
Let's carry on standing
with
the Gospel reading from Luke 1. Great to be able to join together, particularly in the last verse of this today.
Thank you.
some surprising things about the account of the very first Christmas. And some of the surprising things can be found in the boxes that I've got here at the front. And so I just wonder who would help us by coming to look inside the first box and take out what's inside. Okay, brilliant, yeah, you want to come up? That would be great. And Christmas after Christmas, why we never lose the wonder of that mighty miracle that took place, that Jesus, the Son of God, left the glory of the heavens and came to earth as a helpless, tiny baby, a baby who cried and relied on his mum and dad for food, for shelter, clothing and care, just like we did when we were babies. How surprising it is that that is what God chose to do. All right, and so box number two, would someone else come and get out what's inside box number two for us? Please, that would be great. Yeah, James, do you want to come? Just leave it on the floor for us, James. Thank you. So that is the second surprising thing I want to draw out for us this morning, because we would have thought that God would choose people famous and special to bring their baby, bring his baby to, people that you might see in a magazine like this one, very special celebrities who would be seen as prize people, if you like, but God didn't choose people like that at all. He chose a simple teenager, Mary, and a simple man, Joseph, who was a carpenter. God didn't choose extraordinary people, he chose ordinary people, just like us, to bring the Saviour to. And God is still in the business of doing that today. He is in the business of doing extraordinary things through people who may see themselves as the most ordinary. Okay, so box number three, and if someone else, it can be someone of any age at all. Box number three, can you come and open that for us and get out what's inside? Oh, thanks for coming up. What's your name? It's a bit funny, isn't it, to look at? Do you want to just get some out and show people? Yeah, so funny straws, okay, that's right. So I'm just going to pull these out onto the floor. Thank you for coming up to help us. So that's the third amazing thing that I'm drawing out for us today, that God could have chosen absolutely anywhere for his son Jesus to come, and yet he chose this animal's feeding trough to be the place where Jesus would be laid in a stable. It's totally surprising, and that's why the boys, then they headed straight for Herod's palace, because they were sure that that was a kind of place, a palace. They thought that would be the kind of place where this glorious king would be found. And yet we know he was found in a place that we would associate or see it as a place of poverty, a very lonely place. Alright, so we're nearly there. We've got number four to look in there. Four of our five boxes, so number four. Who's going to help us with this one? Okay, that's on. Choose to share this amazing Saviour to and tell this great and wonderful news to. And it's worse than that because in first century Palestine, the shepherds had quite a bad reputation. They were looked down upon by many people in society. So we might think today of the shepherds as people like those who sleep rough on the streets of our towns and cities. And they were quite despised people, and yet the angels gave this good news to them about Jesus. And this was a sign that he would come for each and every person, that there would be nobody who would ever be beyond his reach and the reach of his wonderful and limitless love. And we've got our final box now to have a look inside and put the contents out. So who will help us with the last box? Just one now, come on. Just one to go. Yeah. Okay, thanks. So lovely baby things there, oops, hat, toy, things that we would assume would be perfect presents for a baby. But we know from the gospel accounts that when Jesus was born, the wise men brought gifts that were not like these at all. What gifts did they bring? Just shout out for me what gifts they brought. Gold, frankincense, myrrh. We would think that they were so strange if today someone brought them for a baby in our family. But they were brought because of how Jesus was to be that special one, that saviour, the one whose dying would bring about freedom and forgiveness for all people, once and for all, who looked to him. So when Jesus, the Lord of all, entered our world as a baby over 2,000 years ago, some very surprising things happened, things that we can take away with us in our minds and our hearts into the rest of this Christmas day. And it was exactly what we and all of the world needed, a saviour. Although we have done nothing to ever deserve this amazing and glorious love, and in fact we have each rejected God, even though we might not realise that we have, God chose, he determined to come to earth to save us from the mess that we've gotten ourselves into. And today, as we approach the end of 2021, our living God is offering to all of us, to you and to me, a completely fresh start. He offers to forgive us our sins and to bless us with new life in his name, with the power to become the people that we were meant to be before we were ever created. He offers this gift to every person, and for that reason we're going to have a surprise collection right now, and actually it's a reverse collection. So I'm going to ask Gareth to come up and help me now. of you. Let's have you take the one that you touch. And as you receive this, just reflecting on what I've just said. Thank you for coming to earth to be our saviour. Please forgive us for the ways in which we rejected you and rebelled against you. And Lord, please come into our lives by your Holy Spirit amen this wonderful Christmas day. Lord, we ask that you will be our saviour and our Lord. Thank you for offering us this wonderful gift of relationship with you. Amen. And if there is anybody here this morning who's made that prayer theirs for the first time today, I'd just like to encourage you to talk with me after the service. It would be really good to touch base with you and get to know you a little bit more. I'm going to affirm our faith now, so if you could be able, let's stand and we'll say this all together. share together as God's family, remembering all that we believe. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. To take a seat, we're just going to leave us in a short time of prayer.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, born an outcast and refugee, in weakness and frailty, as we rejoice today, hear our prayers for all those who have no cause for celebration. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the hungry and the homeless, the poor and the unemployed, the oppressed and the exploited, the lonely and the downhearted. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the sick and the dying, the sorrowful and the bereaved, victims of violence and war, all whose lives have been shattered by tragedy and disaster. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, born to set your people free, come again to our world, bringing reconciliation where there is division, and comfort where there is sorrow, hope where there is despair, and confidence where there is confusion. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Come and bring light where there is darkness, and love where there is hatred, faith where there is doubt, and life where there is death. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, come again to our world and bring that day nearer when your kingdom will come and your will be done. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer, for we ask it in your name. Amen.
In praying on in an attitude of prayer, we're going to join together in the words of the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. And to share in God's peace now. And how we're going to do this is open Easter, St James's, during the time of the COVID, so it's with signing, and it's peace with you. So in just a moment we'll offer that in each direction to those around us. So our Saviour Christ is a Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace there shall be no end. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let's share that song. Just to say, time to one another that we share together in Jesus' presence as we come towards sharing in Holy Communion. Okay, we're going to sing again as we prepare to do that in our hearts today. Spirit and restored in your image by his death and resurrection. Amen.
Holy.
You send your Spirit to bring new life to the world and clothe us with power from on high. And so we join with the angels to celebrate and say,
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest.
Father, on the night before he died, Jesus shared a meal with his friends. He took the bread and thank you. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, Take and eat, this is my body given for you. Do this to remember me. And after the meal, Jesus took the cup of wine, he thanked you and gave it to them, saying, Drink this all of you, this is my blood, the new promise of God's unfailing love. Do this to remember me. Grace is a mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Father, as we bring this bread and wine and celebrate his death and resurrection, send your Holy Spirit that we who share these gifts may be fed by Christ's body and his blood.
Amen.
Amen. Pour your Spirit on us that we may love one another, work for the healing of the earth, and share the good news of Jesus as we wait for his coming in glory.
Amen.
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 For honour and praise belong to you, Father, with Jesus your Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
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 Join me in the hearts for what God has done, let us pray together this prayer for after communion. God of Christ, we thank you for your gifts of bread and wine. May friends be for us sources of love and strength during this time of expectation. For the reality of Christ having come to live among us, empower us to be your servants in the world. All honour and glory are yours, Lord our God. Amen. Going to our final carol now, Hark the Heralds. Amen. Go in peace. Proclaim the word made.